Welcome students to this e-learning session. I am Dr. Rimla Mathan. I am going to deal with ergonomics in kitchen designing. All of you know the importance of kitchen in our life. Do you think that there is a need to study about designing kitchen? Today we are going to deal with the ergonomic way of kitchen designing. House is the most important place in a woman's life where she nurtures and cares her family. Kitchen is in the house is the platform where the feeding of the family is done. So, an efficient kitchen design which is convenient to use with minimum effort and maximum comfort will turn cooking from an unpleasant duty to a pleasant one. Application of ergonomic principles or human factors can go a long way in making the kitchen efficient. Let us see how kitchen can be designed ergonomically to make it more efficient, step-saving and comfortable. This module will help you to understand the importance of kitchen designing, which will help to design spaces with ergonomic principles and which will make the kitchen efficient, and you will be efficient kitchen designers or entrepreneurs. Now let us see the objectives. Get awareness on the need for designing a kitchen efficiently. Identify the various aspects in kitchen designing. Study the influence of human factors and to establish the learner's or client's comfortable working levels in kitchen designing. Understand the ergonomic principles in space designing and develop ergonomically viable kitchen designs. You all know the importance of kitchen and the activities done in kitchen. Kitchen, the citadel of civilization, is the foundation on which the home is built up. Kitchen plays a very important role in a woman's family life, and that shows that the women spend 4 to 6 hours per day in an Indian household. In a house, kitchen is the major work center. Majority of the women are employed and there is a high pressure on time and energy. So, a well-organized kitchen with good facilities. Modern kitchen is very different from traditional kitchen. From the picture, you can see that. With the advent of science and technology, many new equipments and appliances which are work efficient and aesthetically designed have adorned the modern kitchen. Kitchen is in a state of revolution with continuous workspaces, fitted storage for labor-saving equipments like mixer, grinder, oven and work centers for standing, cooking and serving, and also modern floor and wall finishes which makes the kitchen the most beautiful room in the house. Hope you have all heard about the modular kitchen, and let us see what it is. Modular kitchens are now popular and they are ready-made kitchen units which are complete in every detail with countertops, storage cabinets, wall and floor, racks and shelves, sink, hob, chimney and sometimes with refrigerator, garbage disposer, dishwasher and water purifier as per the customer demands. This concept of designing modular units with human body dimensions were introduced by the famous designer Le Corbusier is the basis for modular kitchen. You can see his photograph. There are two options for this: carpenter made and factory made. Factory made can be imported or localized. Companies like Sleek Kitchen and Godrej in India are manufacturing the modular kitchen units as per the style and color demanded by the customers. There are different styles of kitchen and can be classified according to the shape of arrangement of the stove, cooking center, sink or the washing center, and work surface, preparation area and the refrigerator. Let us see one by one. They are L shape or broken L or right angle, then second one, U-shape, broken U or corridor, double wall, galley or opposite wall, then one wall or the straight line or the single kitchen, and island kitchen and peninsular kitchen. Now we will see the L-shape or broken L or right angle kitchen. See the picture. Here you can see that the work centers are arranged in an L-shaped pattern. If there is any equipment or door in between the L shape, it is called the broken L. It is considered as very practical and less distance between the centers and leaves room for eating or laundry and divert the traffic when need arise. Then second one is U shape or broken U kitchen. You can see the picture. The three major work centers such as refrigerator, sink, washing area and stove cooking area arranged in a U pattern. This is the most compact, efficient and ideal arrangement for work performance with minimum traffic. Next is the corridor or double wall or galley. This style further reduces the distance between work centers but invites traffic if the doors are located at both ends. Then one wall or straight line or single line kitchen. The arrangement of all the work centers limit itself to one wall and can be fitted into alcoves and concealed when not in use. It is the least efficient due to the insufficiency of space. Then next comes the island kitchen. The main feature of this kitchen is that one of the center of the work triangle will be in the middle of the room. Island unit is a convenience both for the diner and the cook, with extension of kitchen counter where cooking and serving can be combined in one space, which is suitable only for large kitchen. Then comes the peninsular kitchen. This will have a unit free on three sides as you see in the picture, with the other wall perpendicular to the wall or other work centers. The independent side can be utilized as a dining space or a study area for small children, and the mother can monitor them. Why kitchen design is important? Kitchen being the major work center in the house, women need to be busy throughout by cooking, serving, cleaning and washing the utensils, etc. Work will become tedious in case of employed homemakers, especially in the morning. Present day, kitchen should be designed in such a way that it suits the taste of the homemaker, and she should be proud to work in the kitchen, and the kitchen should work for her. Kitchen, it's a specialized workroom where activities like preparation of meals, food and utensil storage, serving, cleaning and sometimes even laundering, entertaining and child care are also taken care of. But we don't know how far the homemakers are comfortable in their kitchen. Studies reveal that they are having discomforts such as neck pain, wrist pain, back pain and knee pain. Working height is of critical importance in the design of workplaces. These photographs show the problems faced by the homemakers. High level of cooking counter, positioning of sink, storage above the reaching heights. Low work surfaces cause a person to stoop, a position which lays stress on the back muscles. For high work surfaces, the shoulders must frequently be lifted to compensate, leading to painful cramps at the level of the shoulder blades, neck and shoulders. Though these kitchens are having modern facilities as we see in the photographs, it is clear that they are not designed to suit the homemaker's convenient working heights. So now let us learn what is ergonomics, its meaning and importance. It is about designing for the people who work or wherever they interact with the product, system or process. If applied, it ensures that designs combine the strength and abilities of people and to minimize the effects of their limitations rather than forcing them to adapt. Application of ergonomics will make the product easy to handle, efficient to manufacture, comfortable and safe to use, and make it fit for the purpose for which it is made. So, meaning of ergonomics refers to the study of work laws which result in efficient adaptation of work methods to the individual's physiological and psychological qualities for better safety, health and efficiency. So, ergonomic in a workplace includes layout or design of the workplace, placement and storage of equipment and environment. So, components of ergonomics means anthropometrics, posture maintenance and space standards. Principle of ergonomics, it is the relationship between the work, worker and the work environment. Work means in the kitchen, it is preparation, cooking, washing, storage and serving. Worker means it is the height, elbow level, comfortable reaching levels, horizontal and vertical of the homemaker, that is called anthropometrics. So, work environment means it is the style of the kitchen, sequence of work center arrangements, and work triangle and color scheme and equipments arranged in the kitchen. The work center arrangements, kitchen designs means arrangement of work centers, their positions and its horizontal and vertical reaching levels. There is a concept called work sequence and work triangle. Arrangement of work centers in the kitchen, it should be flexible, but at the same time, the flow of arrangement should be in a logical progression, like from refrigerator to preparation center and then to the cooking center and then to the sink. So, work triangle, let us see what it is. So, it is the path connecting the refrigerator, stove and the sink, which are the main major equipments. It results in the work triangle, and the total distance between these three work centers should not be less than 3 meter or 10 feet and should not be more than 8 meter or 25 feet. The distance between these three areas should be minimum. At the same time, we have to maintain the space standards. That is, there should be sufficient clearance space, otherwise it will be congested. So let us see the work centers one by one. First one, preparation center. Activities done in this area include cutting, chopping, mixing, kneading, beating, spreading, grinding and other related activities. Scientist Gray in 1997 opines that to ensure enjoyable cooking, preparation center needs ample space, a hard-wearing work surface and a suitable storage of food provision and the equipment close at hand. A refrigerator adds to the convenience of the preparation center. Next, let us see cooking center. It is where actual cooking, boiling, frying, stewing, sautéing, etc. with the help of fuel, it can be gas stove or electric induction cooker or electric gas oven, etc. take place. A location near the sink, preparation and serving center is desirable, and then the next comes the washing center or the sink. This is the most used part of a kitchen and makes a positive contribution to the look and feel of a kitchen. There are different types of sink now available, and best position will be between the preparation and the cooking center and should be fixed near the window so that sink will receive natural light during daytime. Its requisites are regular supply of running water, storage space for used and washed dishes, space for trash and garbage disposal, and counters on either side of sink, space for cleaning utensils and straining food items, a space for soap and detergents, scrubbers, brushes, etc. should be an integral part of sink. Physical comfort of people who do the cooking and cleaning up, way in which each work center is arranged, contribute to the speed, efficiency and the physical effort involved. Ergonomics or human factors engineering involve posture and anthropometric measurements of the homemaker. Postural habit is very important in planning a kitchen. Otherwise, the inefficient design will produce degenerative changes in the body through poor posture, which result in all types of discomforts. Homemaker has to maintain a posture which allows functioning effectively with minimum energy expenditure and minimum strain. Standing posture helps to simplify the job and results in reduced drudgery. Knowledge and application of ergonomic principles in kitchen designs can achieve optimal relationship between the work, worker and the work environment. Anthropometric measurements means they are concerned with the measurements of human body from specified anatomical points, and anatomical measurements of women having different heights help in establishing the maximum and minimum levels of working planes and designing work areas at vertical and horizontal surfaces. But the use of these measurements has not yet percolated while designing kitchen in the Indian households. According to WHO expert committee in 1995, anthropometric measurements are combinations of measurements which are essentials for the interpretation of other measurements. Use of body dimensions such as height, elbow level and hand reach can be utilized in planning ergonomic layouts, in evaluating the area specifications and in designing work surface heights, reach dimensions and zones of comfortable reach, maintaining correct posture at work. Let us see how to determine the comfortable reaching levels. General body measurements like height, elbow level and arm length can be taken as the basis for determining the dimensions of work centers. So you can see the photograph. For determining the working heights, reaching heights of homemakers in the vertical plane, and to determine the width and depth of the work surface, reaching length in the horizontal plane need to be taken. First, let us see the reaching heights in the vertical plane. It includes normal comfortable reach, maximum reach and minimum reach. What is normal comfortable reach? This can be determined by the sweep of hands with the forearms extended, with the upper arms hanging at the side of the body in a natural position. The upper arms moves away slightly at the completion of the drawing of the arc. So, reaching height in the vertical plane. When the arcs are drawn by the left and the right hand intersect each other in front of the worker, and that point is the place of convenient reach. Maximum reach. Arcs are drawn with the upper arm extended fully from the shoulder and not hanging, only one hand at a time. The overlapping point of arcs of both hands indicates the maximum reaching height. This is clear from the photograph. Minimum reaching height is determined by keeping the upper arm close to the hip level and inverted arcs are drawn by both the hands at a time. This determines the reaching height beneath the counter levels or the lower section of the shelves. Fairly comfortable reach. This could be earmarked between the normal and maximum reach, with upper arm raised to be parallel to floor and arcs drawn in a similar manner. This will determine the level to store utensils and the type of built-in storage shelves found in Indian household. Then comes the reaching length in the horizontal plane. This include normal comfortable reach and maximum reach, which can be done in front of a table in a standing posture. This determines the width of the counters. So, normal comfortable reach can be determined by drawing the arcs with the forearms extended and the upper arms hanging at the side of the body in a natural position. The overlapping section of arc is the area in which work can be done more conveniently. Maximum reach. Arcs are drawn with the arms extended and stretched fully from the shoulder, form the maximum working areas. This area indicates the distance beyond which work cannot be done without disturbing the posture. So now let us see how work surface heights can be determined. It is as opined by Gilbreth et al. In 1975, homemaker should stand with her arms comfortably relaxed from the shoulders without stooping and need not have to raise her hands above elbow level. A study conducted by me in 2004 reveals the measurements for kitchen work centers, like for the preparation center, for a lady with an average height of 156 cm, it was shown that 84.3 cm, which is 15.6 cm lower than your elbow level, is comfortable. For the cooking center, the convenient work surface height for cooking can be 73 cm for a lady of average height, which is 27 cm lower than the elbow level. Height of the elbow is an important landmark for determining the desirable work surface. In India, 76 cm or 30 inches, that means 2.5 feet, above the finished floor level is considered as the general uniform height for kitchen counters, though separate counter height for cooking area is not mentioned. While determining the cooking counter height, height of the stove, utensils like pressure cooker or tawa also should be considered. This shows that cooking counter should be 10 to 12 cm lower than the rest of the other counters for the ease of cooking. Next comes the washing center. Height and width of the washing center and preparation counter can be the same. That means 84.3 cm height and width 53 cm, with a slope of 2 cm at the sink edge which will help in draining of water. As per the CPWD specifications, 80 centimeters is the preferable height of kitchen sink fixed above the finished floor level, and the width of the inner side is 45 centimeter and the length of the bowl to be 50 centimeter. Positioning of the tap is also very important. The height of the tap or the water outlet from the counter can be 22.4 centimeter, which allows a mean space of 47.4 centimeter between the sink bowl floor and the tap, for allowing adequate space for washing of utensils used for cooking. Similarly, a distance of 33 centimeter from the counter edge was found to be convenient for the tap position, avoiding strain to reach the tap if fixed very close to the wall on a counter width of 53 centimeter. In that case, the homemaker has to stoop a lot to wash the vessels. Individual differences can be there, but not much significant difference, and hence this can be used as a basis for ladies with average height of 152 to 160 centimeter. Then next comes the kitchen environment. A comfortable working kitchen environment for the homemaker should have good lighting and ventilation, availability of good water and drainage facilities, and accessories required. Now let us see the lighting and ventilation. General as well as task lighting near the stove, sink and dining area is essential. Ventilation should include ventilation below the ceiling, one or two windows, electric fan, a chimney and an exhaust fan. Water and drainage facilities. Direct tap connection to the kitchen is very important. Facility to store water, water purifier and adjustable or movable water tap. Drainage through open drain to municipal drain or soak pit and kitchen garden. So there we can have some accessories in the kitchen also. It can be a chair or stool for rest, radio or music system for relaxation, or view of TV from the kitchen, a wall clock, a calendar, emergency lamp, and aesthetic accessories like paintings or wall hangers, flower arrangement or indoor plants or other curios help in creating a good interior environment. Now let us see some ergonomically designed kitchen styles. U-shaped and L-shaped kitchen with different color schemes can be seen in this picture. Now see the island and the peninsula kitchen. What do you feel? Don't you feel that they are comfortable to work with? I wish that you all will design efficient kitchen for yourself and for others also. Now let us conclude this session. Kitchen being the microcosm of the whole house, there is a growing enthusiasm to have a modern kitchen for all the homemakers. Ergonomic approach will enable the homemakers to design over a ergonomic approach will enable the homemaker to decide over a design to suit her profile for increased comfort and convenience. Less strain, no pain, less time and energy are the benefits of the well-designed kitchen. These resources can be utilized for employment or creative work or health-boosting activities like going to the gym or yoga, and spend quality time with the family, especially with your children. Though considerable progress is found in the kitchen design, style of arrangement, application of ergonomic principles will help us to have a modern and healthy kitchen, which will give a dignity to the household work at the same time to the homemaker working in it. So best wishes to all my students, and thank you.